In the last couple of videos, we've done a lot of manipulation of this trend. We've changed the y-axis, we've zoomed in and out, we've done all that stuff. You may have noticed that at just about every step of the way as I was doing that, let me zoom in here, I would be able to revert it by clicking on this little revert button right here. Now, there's two ways you can do that actually. You can do it right from here, or let's say you've zoomed all the way out here, you want to revert, you can also click on this right here. It just depends on where you are and what's more convenient. They both do the same thing. And what they are doing is they're reverting to the configured settings. In other words, it's the saved settings. So it's an important point to make. All the changes that we were doing here, whether we were changing the y-axis, you know, changing this to an absolute time. Let's go from, say, 200 down to, well, negative 100. You know, let's say that's our y-axis. Even if I were to save this display, if I were to do a file save and save this display, that's not a permanent change. It's not a permanent change because if you look at the configuration, if you go into build mode here, look at the configuration is what we save, not those little changes that you make in run mode. So if you notice, this is still auto-ranging. And the format is database, and we have a single scale versus multiple scales. So that's those are the proper y-axis settings. And similarly, if we take a look here, and let's say we zoom out, we're looking now at 5 days. We got a 5-day trend. Go into build mode. Look at the configuration. The configuration is still the 8-hour trend. So whenever you're clicking on this revert button, whether it's the revert button here, or the one that you'd find over here, whenever you're doing that, what you're doing is you're reverting back to the configuration. And that configuration is handled in the builder screen.